Welcome to the Madison Miller Podcast Special Edition, where I go over every 2023 men's college basketball tournament. This is the 29th of 32 shows. This is the SEC tournament. The tournament will be held at the Bridgestone Arena in Nashville, Tennessee, as it's where it usually is. It all begins Wednesday, March 8th for the first round, second round Thursday, March 9th, quarterfinals Friday, March 10th, semifinals Saturday, March 11th, and the championship Sunday, March 12th at 1 o'clock Eastern, 12 o'clock Central on ESPN. Alrighty. So the seedings for this tournament. Your one seed in this tournament, the Alabama Crimson Tide, number 4 in the country, 26-5 overall, 16-2 in conference play. Your two seed, the Texas A&M Aggies, 18th in the country, 23-8 overall, 15-3 in conference play. Your three seed, the Kentucky Wildcats, 23rd in the country, 21-10 overall, 12-6 in conference play. Your fourth seed, the Missouri Tigers, 23-8 overall, 11-7 in conference play, number 25 in the country. And your five seed, the Tennessee Volunteers, 17th in the country, 22-9 overall, 11-7 in conference play. Your sixth seed, Vanderbilt, 18-13 overall, 11-7 in conference play. Your seventh seed, Auburn, 20-11 overall, 10-8 in conference play. Your eighth seed, the Florida Gators, 16-15 overall, 9-9 in conference play. Nine, Mississippi State Bulldogs, 20-11 overall, 8-10 in conference play. Tenth seed, the Arkansas Razorbacks, 19-12 overall, 8-10 in conference play. Your 11th seed, Georgia, 16-15 overall, 6-12 in conference play. Your 12th seed, South Carolina, 11-20 overall, 4-14 in conference play. Your 13th seed, Ole Miss, 11-20 overall, 3-15 in conference play. And your 14th seed, the LSU Tigers, 13-18 overall, 2-16 in conference play. All right, so let's get to it. First round, Wednesday, March 8th, 13 seed Ole Miss, 12 seed South Carolina. Both these teams have been awful this year. Kermit Davis is going to be out of a job in a week from now. They're led by Matthew Morrell, averaging almost 15 a game. South Carolina has been bad for a while. Remember, there was a little bit of a stretch. They made the Final Four in 2017. That's crazy to think about under Frank Martin. They're led by Gregory Jackson II, averaging over 15 a game. I project Ole Miss 2.7 over South Carolina as a favorite. Total 137 a quarter, so I have Ole Miss into the second round. Second of two first round games, 14 seed LSU, 11 seed Georgia. LSU is just awful this year. Two guys averaging double figures a game, led by KJ Williams. And Georgia, decent-ish start, but fell off in conference play under Mike White, led by Terry Roberts at 13-3 a game. I project Georgia 1.8, total 139 and a tenth, so therefore I have Georgia advancing. Second round, 9 seed Mississippi State, 8 seed Florida. Miss State, under some pressure to get some wins. One guy averaging double figures a game, Tolu Smith. And the Gators, two guys averaging double figures a game. Colin Castellern, we haven't seen him since February 15th against Ole Miss. That's a problem. Will Richard is their other guy averaging double figures a game. But anyway, I actually have Mississippi State as a forfeits favorite, total 133.75. So therefore I have Mississippi State advancing. Second of four second round games, 13 seed Ole Miss, 5 seed Tennessee. Tennessee had a little bit of a blip there towards the end of the conference by losing at the buzzer twice and losing some other games as well. Three guys averaging double figures a game, led by Santiago Vescovi. I project Tennessee 12.7 over Ole Miss, so therefore I have Tennessee advancing. Third of four second-round games, 10 seed Arkansas, 7 seed Auburn. Arkansas started off really well, but like faltered down the stretch big time. Five guys averaging double figures a game, led by Ricky Council IV. 16.5 a game. And Auburn kind of fell off a little bit, but got a big win against Tennessee to really stay the course here. Three guys averaging double figures a game, led by Johnny Broom. I project Auburn 3/10, total 140.75. So therefore, I have Auburn advancing in the last of four quarter or second round games. 11 seed Georgia, 6 seed Vandy. Vandy's come on of late and could enter the at large conversation if it goes on a run here. They have three guys averaging double figures a game, led by Liam Robbins at 15 a game. I project Vandy 2.2 over Georgia, so I have Vandy advancing. And then quarterfinals Friday, March 10th. 19 Mississippi State and 1 seed Alabama. Alabama in the news for all the wrong reasons over the past week and a half or so with Brandon Miller and his situation. He averages almost 20 a game and 8 boards a game. Their next best player is Mark Sears, and after that, Noah Clowney. I project Bama 9.3 over Mississippi State, so I have Bama advancing. Second of four quarterfinal games, 5 seed Tennessee, 4 seed Missouri. We talked about Tennessee earlier. Missouri's coming along well. They've gotten some big wins to really prove themselves a little bit. I personally don't think that Missouri will have as good as a seed as its ranking suggests because of some weird losses and some non-comp play. They're led by Kobe Brown, averaging almost 16 a game. I project Tennessee 4.2 over Missouri. So, therefore, I have Tennessee to the semis, so Missouri won and done. Third of four quarterfinal games, 7 seed Auburn, 2 seed Texas A&M. A&M's come along really nicely in conference play after a tough start to the year. Two guys averaging double figures a game, led by Wade Taylor to fourth. I project A&M 2.8 over Auburn, so therefore I have A&M advancing. In the last of four quarterfinal games, 6 seed Vandy, 3 seed Kentucky. Vandy, interesting team, as we talked about earlier. Kentucky coming along nicely after a slow start to the year and the criticism that the team has gotten. Four guys averaging double figures a game, led by reigning national player of the year Oscar Tshiebwe, averaging over 16 a game and over 13 boards a game. Amazingly enough, I have Kentucky by 8 over Vandy, so therefore I have Kentucky advancing. Semifinals, Saturday, March 11th, 1 o'clock Eastern, 12 o'clock Central on ESPN. 5 seed Tennessee, 1 seed Alabama. Should be a really fun game. I just think that Miller's just going to be heckled in this environment. And Sears and Clowney, they're a good team. And they've handled their situation well. I know they lost to A&M, but A&M needed the game. Bama didn't. So how is Bama going to be under pressure? I do like this Tennessee team's depth with Viscovi and Sakai Ziegler and Olivier Nicomoa, as well as Josiah Jordan James. I project Bama by 3 over Tennessee, so therefore I have Bama advancing to the title game. 3 seed Kentucky, 2 seed Texas A&M. Should be a fun game. Tshiebwe is the best guy on the court, but Taylor, I think, can get some buckets on A&M, as well as Tyrese Radford. But Kentucky has more depth behind Tshiebwe with Jacob Taub and Antonio Reeves and Kaysen Wallace, who I think they need back for this tournament, and let alone the NCAA tournament. I project Kentucky by 0.2 over Texas A&M. So I have a non-chalk championship from a seeding standpoint. 3-seed Kentucky, 1-seed Alabama. Should be a great game. Two big storylines. The Brandon Miller thing with Alabama. Will Alabama be a 1-seed? I think they have to win this tournament, be a 1-seed. Kentucky, I think they're safely in the field regardless because of the recent good run that they've had. With that team coming together, getting some big important wins that they lacked early on in the season. Tshiebwe versus Brandon Miller is going to be a fun player versus player matchup. God, as a sports fan, Kentucky failing, I think, is a huge deal. But in this scenario, I'd rather see them win. I think Alabama mishandled the Brandon Miller situation so bad that I feel like karma's going to hit him somewhere, but I just don't think it's going to be here. I just don't. I have them 3.2 favorites over Kentucky. So therefore, I have the Alabama Crimson Tide winning the 2023 SEC tournament. Alabama's going to be a 1-seed for sure. Unless they lose before the title game even. And depending on how Houston, UCLA, Purdue, and Kansas do in their conference tournaments as well. Because I think those are the five teams bidding for the 1-seeds. And I'm just sick to my stomach of how bad Alabama mishandled the Brandon Miller thing. He should be suspended and not even playing right now because of his situation. And here they are trotting out Brandon Miller, facing the media and dealing with all this crap. And part of me wonders if it's going to hurt them or not. And I think there's a possibility that the karma can come back to bite him and the selection committee puts him on the two line. I really hope it happens. They should have lost to South Carolina after that whole debacle happened and then Miller hit the game winner and had 40-something points in that game. But anyway, I think that Bama's going to be on the one line. A&M, because of their weak first part of the season, I don't think their seeding will reflect the number they have next to their name, similar to Missouri. So I think those teams are destined for like 8-9, something like that. I'd say A&M will be an 8, Missouri will be a 9. Kentucky, I think they're going to overseed Kentucky. They always tend to overseed big name schools. I could see Kentucky being a 7 because I have them in the title game. So I think they'll reward them for that. So I think they're going to be a 7 seed. Probably would have been a 6 if they didn't lose at home to South Carolina. Tennessee, fluky buzzer beater losses. I think they're going to be on the 6th line, if not the 5 line. But I'm going to say the 5 line because I have them in the semifinals. But if they lose to Missouri, I think that they'll be on the 6. But I'm going to say Tennessee will be on the 5. I think Vandy's going to the NIT. I think they have to win in the quarters against Kentucky, assuming they get by Georgia, if they want to be in the field. And if they make the semis, I can see if they lose in the semis to A&M, I can see them being on the bubble and being in Dayton. But I think they're going to be like a 2-seed in the NIT. That's my gut. Florida, I think, will be either in the CBI or the NIT. I'm going to say the CBI. Mississippi State, they have to beat Florida, in my mind. And I think they will beat Florida. If they lose to Florida, they're going to be in the NIT. But if they beat Florida, I think they're going to be, I'm going to say an 11 seed with one of the last two byes. So I'm going to say they're an 11 seed with a bye. So they dodge Dayton by like 1 seed. Arkansas, I think, will be in the field too. I just don't know where in the field Arkansas will be. They've kind of faltered of late, so I could see them on like the 10 line, if not the 9 line. If they find a way to get by Auburn, then I can see them being in the 8-9, but I'm going to say that Arkansas will be a 10. And then Auburn, I'm going to say, will be a 9 because I have them getting by Arkansas. But I'm going to say Arkansas-Auburn determines the 10-9. But if one of them gets by Texas A&M, then I can see the winner of one of those two teams, if they knock off A&M, be on the 8 line. So I'm going to say Auburn to the 9, Arkansas to the 10. Georgia, I think you'll see them in either the NIT or the CBI. Got points as the CBI. And then we will not see South Carolina, Ole Miss, and LSU in any postseason tournament. Most likely to make a surprise run in the conference tournament. That's a tough one. If Colin Castleton can come back for the Gators, maybe. Maybe Castleton from Florida comes back. Maybe they're the team. From a talent standpoint, it should be Auburn or Arkansas, the winner of the Auburn-Arkansas game. And Auburn, I think, is just a up-and-down team. I think Arkansas has proven in the past two. So a team that could make a surprise run, I think, could be Auburn. I think has a possibility to make a little bit of a surprise push. Maybe Mississippi State, with them coming on a little bit at the end of conference play led by Smith. So I would say Auburn, based on its potential, would be my pick to go on like a surprise run in the tournament to potentially steal and make the final and potentially win it from a talent standpoint. All right, odds for this tournament. Alabama's plus 150, Tennessee's 3-1, Kentucky's 450, A&M's 5-1, Auburn's 12, Arkansas's 12, Mizzou's 25, Vandy is 40, Miss State's 50, Florida's 60, Ole Miss 500, same for Georgia, South Carolina's 800, LSU's 1,000. From a value standpoint, a 4 seed at 25-1, I think Missouri has to be the value play. I know I have Tennessee knocking them off in the quarters, but 25-1, Missouri? If they get by Tennessee, they face Alabama with the Brandon Miller situation hanging over them. They can knock them off, and maybe A&M gets by Kentucky, and they face A&M. Why not Missouri? I think Missouri is absolutely the value play at 25-1, led by Kobe Brown. So that would be my pick for the value play. All right, so that's it for the SEC pod. I'll be back with 3 more of these tomorrow. The MAC, the AAC, and the Ivy League.